When you hear the sound of thunder, don't you get too scared. Just grab your thunder buddy and say these magic words. Fuck you, thunder, you can suck my dick. You can't get me, thunder, cause you're just God's fart.
Why are you what the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck?
Yeah, you are, baby. Watch out for the bomb! Oh, shit.
up and do that. I'm out! I'm gonna take my headphone with me. Fuck it.
Yeah, don't play to a goal. Yeah, jam up. Fuck, come on, go, go, go!
Shit, he don't.
Or.
She's good. Didn't reckon I should waste my time killing you. But I felt different.
So it seems.
Thank you for the bits.
Maybe after all this
you
is
did
over,
not have to do that.
I'll go pay her a call.
Thank you.
And the...
Whatever you say.
I'm stimming.
Defensive now. Running Hurricane Rana. Fantastic. Check out this power. Rowdy Buster.
Baszler is struggling. She might have the trick to keeping Shayna down.
Fireman's carry. Up and face.
We can do that. Top ten. Okay, welcome back to my channel. Hi, I'm Lorelei. You know me. I'm Lorelei, aka Wei, and this is the Lorelei Kara official channel. Well, for now. Okay, everybody. Where to go? Wait yourself. How many of you have known me? How many of you have followed me for how long? Some of you have followed me for 4 years, some of you have followed me for 5 years, some of you have followed me for 2 years. And it depends on which platform you found me on.
right? Some of you have actually met me on Mr. Yeah, we go way back. That lady went live at the one of my mods. A long time mod. Although, technically, it was actually a little bit more than that. Because you actually technically followed me on my old channel before I did the rebrand, but anyway, let's talk about something. Some of you have actually followed me from my Mr. Day or my Facebook gaming days or my YouTube. Some of you have actually followed me since 2007. From like when I actually started out really, really young with my first YouTube channel, although I didn't really have much luck with that. I have officially been around since 21 years old. Officially, I've been around since I was 21 years old. I have tried and failed. And then I got dumped up. I got my first PD, thanks to y'all. Even though I got ripped off completely by that company. I was the Jap Gamer Girl. Yeah, I was the Jap Gamer Girl on my other channel. I had this little laptop, gaming laptop, that I would try to stream off of. Which I rented from, I believe it was either Renner Dinner or Aaron. But, yeah, I rented that. You have followed me for God knows how long. That's a long time. A really long time. But I tell you this much. When I first came to Twitch after Mr. Shutdown, I had potential. I had a vision. And I had an idea. And that idea was to create something that was going to be completely different from anything that anybody had never done before. I was going to do the impossible. I was going to create the impossible. And I almost did that. I almost became Twitch partner. I was this close. And then one day, during a live stream one night in my old apartment, My dog is doing that. You are all the idea. Everything I wanted for you. Pretty sure Lady went live with her to do but briefly, probably. I'm not sure, but I know a lot of people did. There was like maybe 40 viewers at the time. And then I had 30 viewers, then I had 50 viewers, then I'm for like the next few days. And then I took a break. I lost everything. Because of one guy. And in 2021, I lost everything. It took me a long time to rebuild. I had like almost 800 followers. And now I'm at 410 followers. Because I blocked somebody recently who is no longer a mod. I just blocked that person recently today, this morning. I am not afraid to call her out. I don't care if you got a big following. I don't care if you got like 12,000 followers on TikTok. She is a narcissist. She is abusive. And she is fucked up transphobic. I will call her out. Anonymous the table, aka Julia Walker. You are now being held accountable for what you texted me this morning when I woke up to go to the bathroom. My friend, a lot of my friends saw what you texted me. And they are telling me that you fucked up. If you want to threaten me by calling the police on me, you are using and enabling white supremacy. But don't worry, I already talked to the police. I talked to the police in your state and my state. They're not going to do anything. Not for you. But they are gonna do something for me. They're gonna file a report for me on my behalf. And then they're gonna give me a copy of that report when I'm going to forward it to my lawyer and to the FBI. Many of you do not know that I have actually been working with the FBI for a long time now. Because we are trying to find my stalker who has been looking at my live stream, who's been trying to stop my platform, my TikTok, everything. Trying anything and everything to try to frame me for something I will never ever do. With it, everything that he is doing right now. Sorry about that, I put the wrong button. Anyway. So before I do my announcement. I want to let you know that did the way it's been taken care of. Don't eliminate the table on Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Thread, every single platform, also known as Julia Walker on Facebook, is definitely going to be held accountable. Nova Dream, who was also on Twitter, aka Kayla Nova, is definitely going to be held accountable for slandering and lying about me. They are now officially at the... What time is it right now? 5:23 p.m.? Okay. So at the 3:45 p.m. Eastern time. Because I just finished my phone call and everything. I had to look really closely because my vision's not that good anymore. So 3:45 p.m., a few hours ago, I had finished my phone call with my lawyer. Down on the table, Julia and Kayla, Nova Dream, is now officially part of a long list of people who is now being sued in a defamation lawsuit. So my lawyer effectively getting everything filed. So even though this lawsuit had been pending for a while, and the fact that it's happened across multiple state lines, it's now a federal lawsuit. We're not going through county, we're not going through state. We are dipping through all the hoops that we are no longer jumping through. We are going straight to federal court. County don't give a fuck. State is really busy taking care of the own shit. Federal court is taking up the call now. So for legal reasons, I will no longer be talking about this anymore. This will be the first and only and last time I will ever talk about this, other than the time that I will upload it on YouTube. So, now I'm going to share my announcement and my plan going forward. Between now until January 2024. In fact, I decided my final dream will be New Year's Day. The last dream ever. The biggest last dream ever. We'll play as many games as we can. We'll go 24 hours. I will have a big blowout. And it will be an honor and a privilege. To say thank you one last time. To say thank you for everything. Let me tell you why. We're gonna stream every week on the channel. We'll do whatever the fuck we want. I don't care what game we're gonna play. I don't care what movie we're gonna watch. I don't care. We're gonna do it all. We're not gonna go by a set schedule anymore. I would show up anytime I want, any day I want. Except for Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Unless I do an early morning stream that I'll pop up occasionally. So, if I decide I want to stream late Monday night, I'll do that. If I want to do Monday morning stream early before I go on my other channel, I'll do that. If I want to do something late night, I'll do that. If I want to stream for 8 hours or 12 hours, I'll do that. But it's my schedule now. It's not yours. It's mine. Between now until January 2024. However, we will do the holiday Sabathon. Well, I would dream all of December to try to get as big as the payout as possible. Okay? I would dream 6 to 8 hours a day. Maybe 12 hours. And I would dream as much as possible throughout December. Except for New Year's Eve. Because we have New Year's Evil on my other channel. And I will be making the same announcement, but a little bit different because I don't want to have to repeat myself. So, if I don't make the payout on this channel, fine, I'll make the payout on my other channel. But I will make a payout regardless. And I have to. Because I need to pay my bills, I need to pay my rent, I need to pay for my disability equipment. I need to pay for a lot of things that I need to take care of. I need to pay for my credit card. And I need to pay for my medical marijuana. So there's a lot of things I gotta pay for. And a lot of things that I gotta save up for. My YouTube channel, I'm not going for YouTube partner. Believe me, I try. I just don't see it happening. I do not see YouTube partner happening. I'm tired. So that brings me to my next point. See, I've been creating content since 2007. 2007. And that's a long time. That's a long time. God, I've been around forever. Like, God knows how long, you know? I started out with an Instagram profile and Facebook gaming. And I had my mixer and all that stuff. There was a lot of Twitter profile, not much. And then I got into YouTube for a little bit. And then I started growing from there. And then I did death work at that point. I did everything. And I worked so many jobs. You have no idea how many jobs I work. I mean, my back is broken from a lot of old jobs. My back is broken from that. That's why I'm pretty much permanently disabled. It's sad, I know, it's sad. And I'm literally a blue-collar type of person. I'm true blue-collar, for any reason. And I work everything. I work really hard. I did film, I did acting, I did retail, I did grocery store, I did desk work, I did porn, I actually work on a fishing boat, on a fishing rod. I even work on an oil rod. I work at a truck driver. I work for UPS. I work for Uber. I work for Lyft. I work at a restaurant. I work at a bar. I work at a bouncer. I work at a zombie extra for a whole bunch of zombie movie and TV show. You definitely will not recognize me with all the makeup, I promise you. I've done every single type of job you can think of, and I am true blue collar. Working class American right here. And I was taught that hard work will get you somewhere, that you will earn enough money, and that people will come to you, the right people will come to you, right? People will spend so much money on you, and then you start creating your Etsy job, and start diversifying your income, and that's what I did. I got sponsorship, I got brand deal. I mean, I even had that HelloFresh sponsorship. I had so many opportunities. And I got very far. And then, I don't know what happened. I lost my job. I lost myself along the way. Because of some really toxic, manipulative, abusive, sociopathic, narcotic, lying, asshole people. And I lost it all. So this is where I am right now. I'm almost 35 years old. That is the age where a lot of kind of creative would start kind of aging out a little bit. In fact, they will try anything and everything, and I do mean anything and everything, to try to be relevant. It's almost impossible as a kind of creator, or dreamer, or gamer, or comedian, to try to be relevant after 35. It's almost impossible. And if you're really, really lucky, after 35, if you're really, really lucky, if you are lucky after 35, and you got the luck, and you trade on your good luck, that's probably the only reason why that's still described to you. And you got kids, you got family. Probably the only reason why that don't describe to you. Oh, well, that and you still make okay, pretty good kind of. But after 35, that's when a lot of 20-something, 18-something teenager will be like, you're done. And that's when you need to start working really hard to try to get people who are 30 and above. And it's gonna be really, really hard to try to get people who are 30 and above. Believe me, it's gonna be hard. I promise you. And I speak from personal and professional experience. I'm almost 35. I'm about to be 35 and wow, almost 2 months. Yeah, almost 2 months. And I'm surprised that there are people after 35 who are somehow lucky. But the viewership starts to grow up a little bit. They start to grow up. I mean, somehow they pull it off, but they grow up a little bit. I know one creator, okay? I'm not gonna name names here, but I know one creator that I follow. Great, great creator. I love her. Amazing person. Who will just die at 40. Just really shy of 40. Almost 40 years old. And somehow she just sit there and have maybe 15 viewers, 14 viewers, sometimes 20 viewers, sometimes 5 viewers, sometimes 10, playing World of Warcraft and a couple other games. And she somehow doesn't have the same mind. But when she started realizing that she was slowly dying on Twitter, to move over to another platform, which I dare not speak his name. Because, let's face it, if you talk about that other platform, you will get banned, or you will lose your platform here. We all know what happened, trust me. Lady Rainlight knows. She witnessed it. It literally happened while I was live. I got cut off. But anyway. So she moved to that platform and now she's doing a little bit better. But we all know that she was dying on Twitter. But it got me thinking. I thought about it. It's something I might do eventually. I mean, let's be honest. I kind of need the money. I gotta earn somehow. But I need to take a break for a long time. So that brings me to my last point. Okay, so everybody's moving to a lot of platforms, right? Everybody trying to give a platform. Everybody dreaming to give a platform. But in the end, okay, in the end, we have to talk about what could my life look like. If and when I do come back. Everything has traumatized me to a point where I need to make the major change. And I literally create a going live notification using the same title, the dream title, and nobody show up for my announcement. Not a single 406 follower. And you're about to miss out on what I'm about to announce. And know what's around it? When I do this live stream and I finish it, people watch it and they watch like almost 200 people or 300 people or 50 people or 70 people will watch it after I finish live streaming. That's fucked up. It's like they want to find some kind of dirt on me. They literally do not want to give me the food. We're talking about 200 dumpy people, maybe 300 dumpy people, or 50 dumpy people, or 70 dumpy people watching my video after I finish going live. On Twitter. Make it make sense, you know? Uh, And that's what I've been trying to figure out. And that brings me to my announcement. I'm retiring. I'm too old for this shit. I love, believe me, you can tell by the sound of my voice, you can tell by the physical expression on my face. You can tell by the depression that I am literally showing in my eyes. That I am retiring. That I absolutely love gaming kind of creation, streaming, all of this. I love it. I love all of it. My passion. My passion is my passion is burning out. This morning I had one of the worst addicted meltdown. A lady on live can attach with it. She can tell you for a fact that I had an addicted meltdown. It was one of the worst ever. And it's now at a point where I'm about to experience artistic burnout and pretty soon artistic shutdown. And the reason why I'm closing my eyes is because I'm trying to prevent sensory overload. I love everything that I have done for all of you. I promised myself I would not cry. It's kind of hard, but I love everything that I have done for all of you. All the comedy, all the silly shit we did, all the game, even the tiny hand. Guy, you have no idea how many wonderful moments we have with the tiny hand. The tiny hand got me to a playlight. I remember all the dancing we did. I remember all the game we played. I remember all the jokes I would tell. I remember all the movies that we all watched together. I remember every Dino Dreamer that we were made out to. And I remember all the things that we made and lost along the way. All the friends. And I remember the pain. That's what I remember the most of all. But it's not the pain of, you know, all those silly challenges that we did, you know, like, you know, the cricket challenge or the wine chip challenge or the bean boggle challenge or anything. That's that kind of pain. It's the pain of all the ones that we have lost along the way. All the people that I had loved a lot along the way. And so, it is with a heavy, heavy, heavy heart that I will have to announce that on January 2nd, 2024, I am saying goodbye. We need to make the final payout. And unless I somehow miraculously became Twitch partner, unless I somehow made it to YouTube partner, unless I somehow pull off the impossible between now and January, I don't see myself staying past January 2024. And I am going to delete everything. Twitch, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, Trovo. Everything. It's been an honor, it's been a privilege. And I am grateful. Believe me, I am more than grateful. I do hope that we make a big and final payout. Even if I have to get some job somehow to try to make a big payout. I want to make one last payout. It's not fair for me to have to get job, but I But at least they're gonna pay out. But I do know that we need to walk away and find a way to have a quiet and peaceful life. I need to find myself again. I need to walk myself back to the woman that I used to be. I don't know what that's gonna look like yet, but I have thought about it a little bit. There is a possibility that I'm going to do it just on Discord. And Patreon. Discord and Patreon. No Instagram, no YouTube, no Facebook, no none of that, no Twitter. And if I do somehow come back to streaming, it will probably be on a platform that I'm not going to talk about. Because let's face it, I might actually need the money. And it would definitely be short term. Yeah, very short term, because I figure maybe a couple months and then earn quiet enough for a really huge payout and then I'm out. And then I'll talk about maybe coming back to Twitch someday. If Twitch is still around. If Twitch is still around, I'll come back. But I do want to tell you that though. It will not be in a way that you think it's going to be. It will be in a way that you will not expect. Lady Rain Live and I had talked about it privately. And let's just say, if I do come back, only Lady Rain Live will know who I really am. That's all you're gonna know. That's all you get to know. But I will tell you that I am tired. And we just lost a follower. Yeah, so whoever is viewing me pretty much lost a follower just now. We have 3 viewers and that just unfollowed me. Okay, here you go. Oh well, bye. Not knowing you, asshole. I'm leaving in January. I don't give a fuck what you think anymore. Go ahead, leave my channel. Bye. We're gonna leave in January. Go ahead, bye. But seriously though, hi Tad. Hey Tad, I'm going to give you a brief summary, okay? Are you ready for this? You're one of my long-time loyal, most loyal supporter. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and be brief. I'm going to give you a brief summary. On January 2nd, 2024, I am leaving all social media platforms. And the same thing goes for my other channel. I'm not making any money. I'm barely surviving. A lot of people are bullying me. People are lying about me and saying things about me that's not true. And I had an autistic meltdown. It was pretty bad. And I had to file a lawsuit. So my lawyer's working on that, and you know, I'm not making any money, I'm not making enough money on Twitter. I'm not making enough money on Patreon. I'm probably gonna lose my only two Patreon subscribers if I don't. Even then, I don't know if I'm gonna keep my Patreon. Which brings me to my next point. If my Patreon loses subscriber and it's gone, and I make a video about it, I don't get any Patreon subscriber, and I lose everything. By January, then the only thing that's left is my Discord. Hold on, Lady Ren Live had an ad. I'm gonna type what I just said to her, so give me 1 second. And I lose everything else by January 2024, and I don't make the final big payout, then the last and only platform I'll keep is Discord for community game night and movie night. And I'll go live on Discord for the next year. So yeah. If I don't make it, to YouTube partner by January, then I'm definitely done. And we gotta figure out how we gotta get there. So if I don't make it to YouTube partner and I don't get one big payout, And I don't get a payout on Patreon, and I lose everything on Patreon. So the last thing would be Discord for just movie night and community game night, that's it. So, yeah. I'm pretty heartbroken. Okay. Lady Rain Live, if you got okay, there we go. You got the message that I type in? And I'm now losing follower on my Instagram account. I used to have like 200, I'm sorry, 330, now 319. Well, it was going to happen anyway. Oh wow, you're right. It was gonna happen anyway, but I still have 115 followers and all that shit on Thread, so I'm surprised that people are unfollowing on Instagram, but they're not unfollowing on Thread. Funny. But yeah. Okay, I think I know why. The person that, yep, I know who unfollowed me. Yeah, I'm gonna be blocking that person very soon. Very, very fucking soon. Alright. Yeah, I know who unfollowed me, so I'm definitely gonna be blocking that person. Okay. I was saying that okay. Give me real quick, hold on. Alright. So I was saying that if I don't make the biggest payout that I can get and I lose my Patreon subscriber and I don't make it to YouTube partner and all of that stuff by January, then the only platform that I will have left is Discord. Discord and Discord only. For community game night and movie night. That's it. I will go live on Discord and I'll say, hey, who wants to play video game with me? I'm gonna delete everything out. And I'm going to end Twitch, YouTube, Patreon, everything. And that's pretty much what I'm gonna do. My website will be gone. Just all of it. You know what? It's actually not a bad idea to do that. Yeah. It's not a bad idea to do that because with everything that's happening in my life, I'm actually really tired, and I don't want to have to deal with this bullshit anymore. I don't. So, I'm definitely ready to delete my Patreon. Yeah, if I don't make the biggest payout or I don't get new Patreon subscribers, none of it, then I definitely want to go ahead and walk away. Definitely want to just say fuck you to a lot of people that I don't like, and just, you know, find some peace and I don't know, just figure our way. Okay, Chad, be safe. I know you've been dealing with the hurricanes and everything, so I know that's right. So be careful down there. Yeah, I know that's been a lot for you, so yeah. You know, I'm actually considering it. Deleting everything and just walking away and not having to deal with YouTube and Twitch and all of that, you know? Yeah. I'm totally considering it. I'm absolutely considering it. So, yeah. And I know that it's been a long journey, believe me. It's been a long journey. I gotta be honest. I'm very, very I don't know, I'm very much done, you know, and I kind of want to really walk away now, you know, I'm just really ready to walk away. And I want to say, okay, thank you, but fuck you, you know what I mean? And that's basically what I've been trying to figure out. So, I don't know. A lot of them good people, and these people in my life have been wonderful, you know, just really wonderful. But it's kind of hard to deal with all of it, and I don't know, not really, I'm trying to find the word. I'm trying to find the word because I feel like there's nothing left to say anymore. I feel like there's nothing left to talk about anymore. And that's what made my better could done. I used to be so vocal about everything. I used to be so vocal about I used to be so vocal about a lot of things. Believe me, I used to be very vocal about a lot of things. Like, really vocal. I don't know. Here's what I noticed, okay? And this is really important. This is really, really important. You have that ADHD, your autism, your depression, all of that, right? That's pretty much my life. What if it's getting to a point where I'm gonna be so quiet? So quiet that when somebody checked on me, they find out that I'm not going to respond anymore. That the sun is no longer on my face, that I have finally left this place that has been so cold. That is when people need to really, really worry. Worry about the possibility that I'm not going to say anything anymore. Worry about the possibility that I'm not going to say anything anymore. Because when I do stop talking, and I go completely silent, what we call an autistic shutdown. Might be the biggest one yet. Just imagine that. I'm in my home. I could be 37 years old. I could be 38 years old. I could be 39 years old. I could be 40 years old. And I could pull out my phone and look at text messages from friends of mine. I could look at a text message from Lady Went Live. I could look at a text message from my friend from California. I could look at a text message from anybody. Any text message. Or somebody trying to call me on FaceTime. Or my video phone. Okay? So, let's say you do that, you text me. And I don't answer for 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, 2 weeks, a month, or 3 months, or 6 months. Or a year. What did that mean? It's a warning sign. It's a warning sign that I am no longer around. At the warning time that I'm basically saying, thank you, but I'm tired. I'm tired, I'm depressed, and I am not alive anymore. It's basically me saying, I love you. But you need to let me go. Let me go. How wild is it to just let it be? Tell it right. So between now until January 2nd, 2024, I'm going to do the best I can have to find and give you the best time of your life. The best time of your life. That's what I'm going to try to do. I want you to have fun. I want you to have a good time. And then we'll have one last to loop. Thank you. Thank you for everything. Well, this is the first time in, wow, almost 5 years that I don't have anything left, to say. I think that I am almost at the point where I'm going to stop talking to him. I don't know when, but it's going to be done. I can feel it coming. My autistic meltdown is becoming a shutdown. Meltdown, shut down. And that is when I'm going to stop talking. I'm getting old. I am getting old. So, how do we proceed from now? How do we go forward? How do we move forward? How do we Phenadron. And never come back. How do I say thank you? For everything. So from now to January 2nd, 2024. We're going to stream as much as we can. And there will be days where I'm going to take a break on the channel. And then in December, we're going to do our holiday marathon, try to get the biggest payout as we can, and walk away. We go to bed, we walk away. And we say thank you. Happy holidays, happy new year. And then, we're good. It's been an honor and a privilege. I want to end LK the Horror Nerd and the channel on January. I really do not want to announce that on my other channel. I don't want to do that because I love Horror. I love Horror. I love everything about Horror, and but people have given me no choice. They have given me no choice. Believe me, I have tried everything. I have been around for so long. So long. You have no idea how long I've been around. And God, I'm tired. God damn, I am fucking tired. Also, another piece of announcement. Who wants to buy my streaming gear? Who wants to buy my face cam? Who wants to buy my speaker? I want to buy what's left of my PT. I'm going to be selling my PT for parts. I'm going to get a new PT just for me. Just for me. Just for game. No dream, no nothing. Just for game. I'm going to get a brand new PT. I want to buy... I want to buy that monitor right here. You can have it. I don't give a fuck. You can take it. It's yours. You want my character card? I'm gonna get a new one for my Discord community anyway. So that way I can dream to just my Discord community. Yeah, well, we're gonna make them change it here. Yeah, I'm giving up a lot of things. I'm gonna start selling online. I'm gonna sell everything I can. Yeah, I'm done. The telephone can go. There's a lot of things that can go. I'm gonna tell everything I can. I'll take it to everything the store that I can. I'll tell online. I'm gonna tell everything. So, yeah. I don't care if I go to GameStop, I don't give a fuck. The only thing I'm keeping is my PlayStation, my Xbox, my Nintendo Switch. That's the only thing I'm keeping. I will get my friend. I'll create a profile so that, you know, I can stay in touch with my dreamer friends that I like and describe to them once a month or whatever. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use my prime description and describe to one dreamer friend I like and three other dreamers that I will pay for it. So that's what I'm gonna do. I already know who I'm gonna describe to. Yeah, my top five. That's what I'm gonna do, my top five. Oh yeah, I'm gonna do the turbo. I'm gonna do the turbo and my top five driver. Yeah, my top five dreamer, I'm gonna pick my top five dreamer. Top five dreamer and the turbo. But only one dreamer is gonna get my prime every month for the rest of my life. And I know exactly who. I'm pointing. Yeah, you're gonna get my prime every month. Every month you're gonna get my prime. Every month you're gonna get my prime. But I need to create a new account though. And make sure that nobody knows my name. So when I tell you that that's my account, make sure that you nobody knows, alright? So when I create a new Twitch account for just viewing and describing and doing bits and all that stuff, I will tell you what my username will be, but only you will know. But nobody else is gonna know. I have the perfect username. The perfect username. Oh yeah. But yeah, you and I, we will talk about it when we chat, alright? So that's a promise. That's a promise. I will text you personally. Yes, I will text you and I will tell you what my username is gonna be. But yeah, So it's now August 30th. How many months? Let's see. I'm gonna do the countdown real quick. Hold on. Okay. Exactly 4 months from now. From today until 4 months. 134 days until 2024. So yeah. So that's what's going to happen. Yeah, 2024 will be a leap year. I had to look really close though. Yeah, because my vision couldn't work. But yeah, 4 months from now to January 2nd. 4 months. Well, that's cool. That's cool. So yeah, from now to January 2nd for 4 months, we have a lot to do. So we need to make the biggest payout possible by end of December, hopefully. That's what I'm hoping for. Because I know the payout that every January, I'm sorry, January 15th, right? Yeah, the 15th, every 15th, yeah. So we need to make the biggest payout possible. We gotta go big. We gotta go big. That's what I'm trying to figure out. We have the holiday subathon. What if we did 2 weeks of the holiday subathon? 8 to 12 hours a day. Or I'm trying to die. I'm trying to die if we do the holiday subathon on the channel or the holiday subathon on my other Twitch channel and my New Year's Evil and all that stuff. That's what I'm trying to figure out. So what you thought? Because I know the channel is kind of dying a little bit, and I know I had like, hold on, let me check. I'm checking right now. I'm looking at the affiliate tab right now. See how much money I have on this account. Yeah, I'm trying to see how much money I have on this account, so. Payout. Okay, there we go. I can't do too well, but. Okay. So your payout is. There we go, earning. Okay, right now I have $19.45 on this account. I have $19.45 on this account. So I'm trying to figure out if I go on my other account, figure this out. So that's what I'll be trying to figure out right here. Because my other account will probably be. Yeah, I'm thinking. I have $25.32. So I'm actually closer to the $50 payout, but I want to go big between now and January on that channel. Okay, so $25 on my other account, $19 on this account. So, Lady Ren Lai, that is my question. What is the best option to try to do a holiday subathon for like 3 days or 1 week on this channel? To get maybe a $50 payout. And then on my other channel, get the biggest payout possible during my New Year's Eve, my Halloween stuff, okay, Halloween and New Year's Eve. I could do that. And that's my birthday. Which is like the day before Halloween. So I would celebrate my birthday on my other channel. I would do all that HorrorNerd experience back on my other channel. We know that. And then there's New Year's Eve on my other channel. So I could do maybe all three bid events and get closer to the payout and try to get the biggest payout possible. But on this channel, I could get like $50 or $100 for the holiday. Yeah, I could do that. Yeah, let's do that. We do 1 week from like Christmas to New Year's Day. But I'm not streaming on New Year's Eve on this channel, but I'm streaming on the other channel. And then try to stream maybe a 2-3 more days so I can have just a little bit extra money to try to get past $50. Yeah, I wanna try to get $50 to $100 at least on this channel before January 15th. And make sure that last until January 15th. So that could work. That could definitely work. I would have to drink and build. Get them job. To strive for. Well, you wanted to drive on like Christmas week. That way it actually goes past January 15th. The payout would definitely happen by January 15th for sure. So if we do the holiday double on the Christmas week, all the way to New Year's Eve, not New Year's Eve, but New York Day. And I finished on January 2nd. Yeah, that could probably work. Yeah, no problem. No problem at all. All we gotta do is stream on Christmas week. And New York Day. So we can do that. No problem. On this channel. And on my other channel, we got my birthday, Halloween stuff, New York Evil. That will get me the better payout more than the problem top. Okay. Ah, lady in life. Got it. But yeah, I figured it out. I figured it out. I already figured it out. We got it. So we just gotta like try to get closer and then. So we just build it up a little bit, and then get to Christmas week. That's what we gotta do.